around this morning, so I have a better understanding of this whole situation with the principal and what is involved. And I must say, after listening, I'm quite clear in my mind that I am happy with the fact that the Mahal father put down their foot and to do or take the actions that they took. Because far too long I've been noticing school children going to school and the manner of dressing is like if they're going out on dates.
All right. Thanks very much for your perspective. We'll continue to take your calls again. 627-4106, 627-8232. Let's see if we have another call on the line. This one is from Shagwanas. Good morning, Shagwanas. Hello, good morning. Okay, Shagwanas has gone off the line. 627-4106, 627-8232. Before we take another call, Ms. McIntosh, do you understand the point that might be raised about the whole question of standards? There has to be standards, whether
it's
religion-based, religious-based, or however-based, and that a school board, denominational it may be, will do whatever it takes to maintain those standards, even if it is coming up against the school's principal.
Well, I understand that. All schools possess core values. All schools possess core values that define their operations. But in the face of anyone, you know, not adhering to those core values, that does not warrant a principal being locked out of a school.
Okay, we'll develop that in a moment. And I know you wanted to make the point about the whole question of whether there is discrimination in schools, and we'll talk about that very quickly as well. But we have Princess Town on the line who's been waiting. Thanks very much for your patience. Good morning, Princess Town.
Hello, good morning to you and your guest.
Good morning.
It's very unfortunate in this country when, you know, we see race as an issue, how we deal with everything. However, I hope this situation gets resolved. But however, I would like to know what your guest can say about principals who do not allow students at this point in time to not wear hijabs at their school. I'd just like to know what is her take on that and what this thing should be done to the principal of that school as well.
Okay, before she responds, let's take our final call on this segment from Arima. Good morning, Arima.
Hello, good morning.
Good morning.
Let me first identify myself because I'm sure that my voice will betray me. I'll be the former principal of both a primary and a secondary school. I've been a former president of Twitter, and I'm a president sitting on the Dean of National Board.
Good morning, Mr. Garcia.
I begin by saying that I am in total agreement with the stand that has been taken by Mr. McIntosh. The issue is not the board, really, or the issue is not the conqueror, but the issue is the way the Mahasabha board is treating the principal by attempting to prevent us from performing our duties. Mm-hmm. And that is what we need to discuss, and we need to have some clarification by the authorities on. It is a bad move by Mr. Satmaraj. It is a move that, if it is taken further, might destroy the whole system of Dean of National Education in our country, and it's something that we have to fight against.
Okay, so thanks very much, Mr. Garcia, former tutor, President Anthony Garcia, endorsing your own position, Ms. McIntosh. But isn't that an exaggeration? We've had these situations before, and as with the earlier caller mentioned, there was an issue when a young Muslim girl was not admitted into, I think, Holy Name Convent.
Holy Name Convent.
It went to court. It became a big issue. People were saying all sorts of things about Muslim people, and now it just happens that this is a Hindu issue now.
Yes, but Muslim girls, I want to answer the caller. Muslim girls have a legal right to wear their hijab wherever they wish to wear their hijab.
Yes.
That is their legal right. That was settled in court.
Yes. But on the issue as enunciated by Mr. Garcia, that this could destroy the entire education system and so on. Isn't that
you see, this is, as Mr. Garcia said, the ministry is going about this the wrong way. And the Minister of Education has been, well, except when he responded in Parliament, been very silent on the issue. And you see the ministry dragged its heels on this, and they should have taken a firm stance on this matter and have instructed the board how to operate and should have insisted that the principal be allowed to perform her duties and responsibilities uninhibited, you know. And if there are issues, those issues could be taken up with the Ministry of Education and referred to the Teaching Service Commission. But not locking her out and then going to press charges against her and agents of the Ministry of Education, etc.
Well, we have to leave it there. I know you wanted to raise some other points, but time has run out on us. But thanks very much for making yourself available to share your views. And indeed, it is something that, as we say, it won't go away anytime soon, because when it comes to the issues in Trinidad and Tobago, from the moment there is any indication of affinity to religion, race, or anything like that, there are other issues. But as Ms. McIntosh is saying, she's insisting that this is about the principal and her role in the school, and that it is not proper to just simply lock her out, just like that, as she is maintaining. We have the news for you. We're not locking you out of the program. We'll have the news, and then Business Breakfast will be with us at the start of the second half.